Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the first session, to the opening session of the Clio Innovation IUEAN MP course. It's my honor to be here today with you, and it's a pleasure to be in this city, because this is a great city. I've been here once, and my memories about that is really, really, really good. So I hope we all enjoy the course, and I would like first to introduce people who are in this session with me. On my right, on the left, you have Rosario Utes. She is a person from the IMTEF, we call in Spain INDEF. She will tell you what it is exactly, and she is the organizer of this event. And then on my left, you have Gordon Gabri. She is the co-director of this course with me. She belongs to the CNIIE, which is also an organism from the Ministry of Education in Spain. And she will introduce herself to, and she will explain to you more things about that. So I will first, Rosario, you have the floor. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Alina. Thank you, everybody. Buenos días. Soy Rosario Aundes, como acaba de decir Elena. Soy la representante del Ministerio y dentro del Ministerio del Instituto Nacional de Tecnología e Información del Profesorado, que es la unidad del Ministerio que organiza esta convocatoria, es decir, desde el momento que se piensa los cursos que hay en las distintas sedes, a través de un convenio con la Universidad de Méndez Pelayo, llevamos a cabo estos cursos cada año. Este año siempre se hace un curso para el profesorado de idiomas. Este año nos ha tocado a vosotros, a los maestros de infantil y primaria. Dentro del ITED hay muchísimos programas y distintas convocatorias, pero aprovecho la ocasión para recordaros que a vosotros concretamente os afecta el programa de estancias profesionales, que también se lleva desde mi unidad de área de formación, que son visitas a centros públicos, centros educativos europeos, en general para practicar durante 2 semanas el idioma y conocer otros sistemas educativos, otras metodologías. Lo digo porque hay distintas convocatorias que podéis acoger, que están abiertas a vuestra participación. A lo largo de esta semana vamos a hacer 30 horas lectivas y posteriormente, a partir del mes de septiembre, vais a hacer otras 20 horas online. Es importante, y ya lo hablaremos el equipo de profesores, que desde ya empecéis a pensar lo que vais a hacer en la fase online. Al finalizar la fase online se os acredita con 50 horas de formación docente. Durante esta semana, además está deciros que es importante la puntualidad, que habrá que firmar hojas de asistencia que estarán a la entrada del recinto. Abajo, ahora cuando pasemos al aula que está abajo, veréis que está a la entrada a la derecha unos listados que tendréis que firmar durante la primera hora de la mañana y a la primera hora de la tarde. Luego los recogeremos y se considerará pues eso, la parte proporcional de asistencia. Es requisito asistir al 100% de las sesiones para poder acreditar. Ahora ya hemos pasado los derechos de imagen y en principio hemos detectado que hay 2 personas que no quieren que se las graben ni que se las fotografíen. Pedimos, por supuesto, nosotros con el equipo técnico lo tendremos en cuenta y os pedimos siempre que en las actividades que sean de grupo, que se vayan a hacer fotos, os apartéis un poquito para facilitar la tarea de registrar imágenes y registrar los vídeos, que luego se van a facilitar también para que tengáis. Os pido también que hagáis todo lo que podáis dentro de vuestras posibilidades, difusión del curso a través de las redes sociales, no solamente para hacer fuera, para que la gente conozca lo que hacéis, lo que se puede hacer, sino para que vosotros mantengáis una red interna de contacto y en lo sucesivo os sigáis los unos a los otros. El hashtag os lo pondré debajo en la pizarra cuando bajemos a la hora. También os daré un número de teléfono, que es el teléfono que el Ministerio nos facilita a mí durante esta semana, por si hubiera cualquier incidencia, cualquier emergencia. Nosotros como Ministerio estaremos pendientes de que todo vaya bien, junto con la UIN, que lleva las cuestiones de infraestructura y los... Bueno, pues os deseo una semana muy profitable. And now we can speak English from now. Okay, thank you very much. Oh, como Ministerio de Educación hablamos siempre en castellano, porque es la lengua oficial. A partir de esta presentación, se supone que todos vamos a hablar en inglés. Okay, everybody, thank you very much.
Bueno, buenos días a todos. Yo soy Coanga Ruiz, también vengo del Ministerio, vengo del Centro Nacional de Innovación e Investigación Educativa, el CENIE, que no sé si lo conoceréis, pero explicaros un poquito lo que es. Es una unidad que, como INTEF, pertenece a la Dirección General de Evaluación y Cooperación Territorial. Bueno, el CENIE es una unidad que genera conocimiento e innovación dentro del sistema educativo. Y está dividida en 5 proyectos que quizá conocéis, que son alfabetizaciones múltiples, convivencia, apoyo educativo, y luego está la unidad a la que yo pertenezco, que es lenguas extranjeras y lingüismo. Nosotros en lenguas extranjeras coordinamos distintos programas, como el de lengua y cultura portuguesa, el bachillerato internacional, y llevamos la enseñanza bilingüe en Ceuta y Melilla, que ha comenzado en este curso 16-17. También llevamos el convenio que tiene el Ministerio con el British Council, que está en 87 colegios de primaria y 53 centros de secundaria en 10 comunidades autónomas y 30 familias, que quizá conozcáis. También llevamos los programas de inmersión lingüística, de colonias de verano para alumnos de primero y segundo de la ESO, 1000 alumnos que se van cada verano. Y el programa de inmersión de primavera o de otoño, donde 210 centros se van durante una semana con sus centros educativos, con dos profesores, durante una semana también dentro del territorio, pero en inglés. Un poco para promover el aprendizaje del idioma. Como cada año nosotros trabajamos conjuntamente con INTEF, en la organización de estos cursos de verano, y este año, como nuestro propio nombre indica, hemos querido organizar un poco un curso en innovación, ¿no? Que no fueran los temas de siempre. Entonces hemos querido trabajar un poco en coordinación con Elena, pues mindfulness, el pensamiento de diseño, las tecnologías de información y comunicación, un poco por darle un toque, pues eso, innovativo al curso. Y pues nada, esperando que con esto cojáis muchas herramientas que luego podáis utilizar en vuestro día a día en clase, y pues dar las gracias a la UIC, lógicamente, por permitirnos organizar este curso, y lógicamente dar las gracias a mis compañeras Elena y Rosario por su trabajo y dedicación en la organización del curso. Muchas gracias.
No sé si como última parte de esta intervención que decía...
Ahora.
Sí, mejor. Decía Rosario, y efectivamente en el Ministerio de Educación Español pues se debe hablar español, pero de cualquier manera esto es un curso pensado para profesores de inglés con temática skill, y voy a pasar a describir un poco los contenidos del curso, voy a presentar al profesorado y un poco voy a contar qué vamos a ir haciendo para que tengáis una idea un poco general del curso. Sin embargo, antes de pasar a esa siguiente parte de la sesión, me gustaría saber si tenéis alguna pregunta, algún comentario, si tenéis así de lo que se ha dicho. Tampoco hay mucho supongo que preguntar, pero si necesitáis preguntar algo, pues os cedo la palabra por si hay alguna cuestión que queráis comentar en este momento. No, fantástico. Bueno, pues si no importa, I feel more comfortable. I always take as a teacher. I always stand. So if you don't mind, I will stand. I hope you can listen to me. If not, please raise your hand, and we will manage somehow. Because I don't have microphone if I stand, or do I?
Am I?
Well, let's try it. Can you listen to me?
Yeah.
Okay. That's it. Thank you.
So that's it. Okay. Oops. Okay, well. That's it. Okay. So first, concerning the title, as you can see, it's called Innovation Within Play. Why Innovation Within Play? Because as you know, many scholars and many researchers are writing and are doing their work on innovation, on with us an innovation. But the purpose of this course is which will be to design a course for teachers. It will be a very practical course where we will see how to innovate within CLIL. So the things that we are going to see CLIL as an insider, we are going to look at CLIL as teachers. And then from that on, we are going to design, we are going to experience some ways to do different things within CLIL as teachers, primary education within CLIL. That's the main goal of the idea, and that's why the position within CLIL. Sorry to tell you the word. So, and then the keywords that you have here are mindfulness, which is a quite new thing, then design thinking, and then ICT. So you are going to see different things. I hope you really, really enjoy the course, and we are very happy with the teachers. I have to say that we have a lot of support with the teachers, and we are excited about being here. All of them are saying, I can't wait to see the people, I can't wait to see the students, can't wait to start, of course, because we are really, really excited. So we are very happy to have you here. And my first words must be those for you. Thank you for joining the course. Thank you for doing the best, because what we think that's the best. And we really hope that at the end of the course, you can say, we have learned something. If that is, we will be very happy with the final conclusion, with the final results of the course. So that's it. This presentation, as I said before, is going to be divided into two main parts. The first part, I'm going to do a theoretical discussion that I would like to share with you about why I decided to design this course. Why content, why we wanted to, why we thought it was necessary, and why we thought it would be nice to do this such a course like this. And in the second part, I'm going to describe one by one. I'm going to introduce the pictures, I'm going to introduce the title of the presentations, and also we are going to, talk a little bit about the main topic of each presentation. So, we are going to divide the course as a theoretical and as a practical thing. So, it's going to be mainline the course along the week. So, in the theoretical backdrop, we are going to discuss bilingual education, probably not only, but because you are all experts in bilingual education, you are all teachers working in bilingual education, but probably it would be nice to see what people say about that, it would be something very short. Then we will go to CLIL innovation, what are people saying about CLIL innovation, and the main question, why it's good. And then, as I said before, we are going to do a general description of the general contents of the course, and then one by one we are going to describe the features, the content, the workshop, the lecture, one by one, so that you can see. Please, if you have any questions, if you want to say something, please don't hesitate to interrupt me. I will be very happy to do this as participatively as possible. So, beginning as a direct backdrop, you know, bilingual education is one of the hottest topics in research, also in education in the world. Bilingual education is needless to say that it's needed, that it's important, and also that it's supported by main institutions in the world. The OECD, UNESCO, Council of Europe, everybody is more than sure that we need to foster, support, implement, and work on bilingual education as researchers, as politicians, as teachers, as whoever. Bilingual education is very, very important. I think we don't need to discuss much deeper. But I would like to tell you one anecdote that happened to me 2 days ago. It was on Friday, well, 3 days ago. I don't know the day I'm living. It was Friday. I had a PhD student. Her name is Cristina Díaz. She knows what I'm talking about her. She's doing her PhD with me, and she's working on audiovisual things, etc.
I mean, she comes from an educational background, she's not very skilled in English, and she has decided to stop all her research right now. She's going to go to the USA for 1 year, she's going to improve her language, and then when she comes back, she's going to resume her work, her research work with me. English is that important nowadays, second languages in general are that important nowadays that people are ready, more than ready, to change all their lives to learn a second language. But learn a second language is not today enough to be able to communicate in such a way as I to something. We need to be proficient in English. And pay more and more is being more important than, because we are scoring big levels of English more and more. We are more present in the European Union and in the world. So, I mean, we are proud to say that. We are proud that we have important bilingual education programs, and we are, I mean, a reference for many countries and for many cities and for many programs who are looking at carefully what we are doing in bilingual education. So, that's it. I mean, it doesn't, I don't need to be more, I mean, to demonstrate further that bilingual education is the kind of education we need to bet and we need to foster now. Why? Among others, because it, I mean, has demonstrated cognitive, intellectual, neurolinguistic abilities for students, for participating students, but also because socio-culturally speaking, participating people in bilingual education also has four big levels of skillfulness. We will see probably this afternoon with Elisa. She will speak a lot about intercultural education with them, which is something quite new we'll discuss about that. Also, academic people are really, really good when they are involved in bilingual programs. And finally, job opportunities. Needless to say, people who speak more than one language are people who have big opportunities to get employed in international companies, enterprises. So, the benefits of bilingual education. The best for bilingual education is very clear nowadays, so no need to go deeper into that. Let me give you a simple example of what the Council of Europe says about bilingual education. Let me read that briefly. It says, in dealing with different models of bilingual, so you can't see that, standing here, in dealing with different models of bilingual education, it should bear in mind that this form of education has proved its effectiveness in numerous situations throughout the world. This concerns the proficiency in both languages, L2 only in transitional programs, as well as the results in the different topics taught throughout through another language. So, the Council of Europe, I mean, said that very clearly. We must do a big thing, because it's effective, because it's important, and people must command at least 2 languages. So, now that we know that bilingual education is the kind of education, let's go to why innovation will be clear. Dawn Coyle, probably you know her, she is a reference for those of us who work in bilingual education, mostly in CLIL programs. She was a person who designed the triptych for CLIL. So she's very well known. She said in 2009 those two important things. Look at that. She said, innovation is linked to action, creativity is thinking. So if we are going to work in CLIL, and we are, I mean, our goal is to innovate within CLIL, we must be ready to do things which are connected to action. But at the same time, she very intelligently connected the action with the creativity. And she said, creativity is connected to thinking. So can you follow the line? Probably you are now following my idea. The idea that we had was we need to innovate in living. Well, many things have been done. Many things have been reported to be good things, to have good results in living. But we need to do something different if we want to be a reference for the rest of the world. But at the same time, we need to do something related with thought. That's why design thinking got into action. So,
keyword that you need to be bear in mind is innovation thinking action. Okay? That's it. Then, look at that. In 2014, 5 years later, Holt, Marsh and Coyle said, since innovation and change make demands on those involved, developing professional learning communities, sorry, country labs, within and between institutions for sharing resources and ideas is a practical way forward. More clear digital networks are emerging, and within teacher support, materials bank, and repositories. So, look at the words that I have signaled in bold. We have innovation, we have change, and we have learning communities. Those are, again, keywords in our course. They declare that we think we need to talk about innovation, we need to talk about learning communities, learning, meaning the learner must be the center of the CLIP programs, and also change. So, more keywords to add to our program, right? And then finally, Coyle again said she is a reference. Coyle again, in 2015, 1 year later, she said, my vision for the future is that CLIL, as a concept or as a term, it doesn't matter, won't even be used. In 2014, technology and financial changes are pushing individual societies of the Western world towards becoming much more pluralistic. Societies are changing, and we are part of that change. The schooling system also has to change, but we all know that it's incredibly difficult for education systems to change as quickly as society does. It takes time. So that was like the quotation that I wanted to show you. Leo said that we need to innovate, we need to change. It doesn't matter if it's clear or not, we need to be different. Because to introduce a little change in a big machinery, such as an educational system, it doesn't matter if it's Spain, the United Kingdom, Copenhagen, or Italy. It doesn't matter. We need to do little things to introduce little changes to be able to produce a little change that little by little goes on and on. So, the keywords here are innovation, our learning communities, our technology, schooling, and it's different. So that's why this course was born. It was born with the idea that for a group of teachers, that let me tell you, it's not so frequent to have teachers who want to do courses in the summer. That's kind of sacrifice for many of you, and we really appreciate that. And we know that sometimes it's difficult for teachers to get out of their own homes when now it's time to rest. So now you are in a different city, you are working, you are attending a course, a specialization course. So we thought that all this theoretical background should be brought into the classroom. So we are going to show you how we, with those ideas that we have, tracked, from the literature, we have designed a course. Let me tell you that when we designed, Colonga and I decided to design a course, it was such a challenge because we really knew what we wanted, but we needed to find key people who we knew were experts, and we are proud to say that we found them. And also, there are people who are ready to be working in a period of the year that is not so easy for many of us. Some of us are like marking exams, are assessing final degree dissertations in our universities, etc. So, it's a hard time for us. But we were all excited, as I told you before. We were very happy to be here. We were proud to be part of this course, and we found the people for this course. So, let me give you the ideas of the people, of the topics, how we, materialize all these theoretical concepts into big areas of this course. Remember when Colin said technology is important for innovation? In technology, we design kind of two workshops, conferences, lectures. The audiovisual translation exercising that will be delivered by Dr. Alberto Fernandez. She is PhD from the University of Oviedo. And also, holistic methodologies in 21st century quill, and that will be delivered by Professor Huertas in University of Oviedo. So in technology, we identified those areas that were quite new in quill. The second thing, that the second keyword, was creativity and thinking. Those were quite new. We haven't seen much about that within CLIL. So I think it was a big bet that we decided to put in the front, of course, in the main title. And as you will experience, mindfulness and design thinking in that scale. The third keyword was pluralistic. And in pluralistic, definitely we are talking about inclusive education, and interculture has to be along with that area. So interculture and integration were two of the keywords that we identified, two of the topics in the program. So as you can see, what we did was to identify the main keywords in the literature and make them topics in our report, right? The fourth area was schooling. Remember when Doug Coyle said, schooling is one of the biggest challenges because to introduce a little change in school is very difficult. So in that part, we identified the input and output from consumers to producers that will be delivered by Professor Rogan. He's a doctor, he's a very good teacher, and he's working in a context, in a school context. So you will see how interesting and how innovative is what he has to say. Then learning communities, cooperative learning, that will be delivered by me. I hope you enjoy it. We'll talk about that later. And if not, please honestly let me know. I will change it. And finally, time. With time, you know, teachers are really, really pressured by time. Sometimes we don't have the time to do the activity. We don't have the time to explain something. We don't have the time to do that activity, whatever. So what we did was, let's talk about flipped classroom. So that will be within, but again, it will be delivered by Matthew Johnson in the University of Alcalá de Henares, Centro Cisneros. So these are the main ideas, how we coped with the literature and make it, I mean, into a course, we convert it into a course. So these are the main, you can't read them, and no problem with that, because we are going to examine one by one. These are the topics, the 12 workshop and lectures of this course. By the way, no need to take pictures, no need to take any, because it will be on Moodle in 5 minutes. I mean, it's already on Moodle, but it will be made visible for you in 5 minutes, so you have everything there. So as PDF, you can download and use it as you want, okay? And those are, I mean, the second part, those again. So let me, review one by one. I have time, so if you have questions, if you want to know anything, or if you want to remark something, please let me know. We will be ready to discuss. The first conference, the first workshop will be today at 12 o'clock, and it will be delivered by me. I thought that, honestly, my idea was that cooperative learning probably is something that you have some time done in your life. I don't know if I'm right or wrong, but cooperative learning is not that new. So someone could think, why cooperative learning in an innovation course? Because my idea was, kind of mixed idea. My first impression is that whenever I have gone to schools and observed teachers, they are doing some kind of personal, which is good, cooperative learning techniques. But some people think that group working is cooperative learning, which really is not. So my idea was to discuss the main principles of cooperative learning and try to combine it with some kind of innovation within CLIL. So I will tell you in my workshop later how to make, bring the literature into the classroom and how to make it practical. But the real cooperative learning, and what are the differences between cooperative and collaborative learning, which is not the same thing, and also how to make it into a play activity. I'll give you an example, and then I will ask you to work and give me your posters that will be shown for the rest of you. This probably is going to be the technique for most teachers. What we want is to show you the literature, to show you some things will be like, I said to them, no more than 15, 20, maximum 30 minutes of theoretical background, then show them practical things and then let's work together. Because honestly, I think that one of the best things here is that we as teachers are going to learn probably more than you as students. So this is our goal, let us know what you do with this, and let us know how you do it. That will be very interesting. So this is the idea. The idea will be to examine cooperative learning, make it with some kind of innovation, and also let me see how you work with this, okay? So that, summary is like cooperative learning is reported as an essential tool for clear primary education teachers in the literature. You can find many authors declaring and betting for cooperative learning. It fosters interaction among students, which is a key for second language learning. It promotes responsibility and it makes a crucial supporting tool for teachers when seeking both students' integration and the increase of their motivation, which is also the goal. The goal is to motivate students within a clear classroom, okay? So that will be the first one. The second workshop will be delivered by Dr. Elisa Pérez. She is here with me today because she will be taking part in the second half of the day, 4 o'clock. And she will be talking about interculture and healing. Why this topic, as I told you before, integration, inclusive education? Attention to diversity, that's important in the key area of CLEE. And interculture is kind of a controversial topic because many people think that it's quite difficult, but many people think that it's easy to identify an intercultural, to work with an intercultural background in some areas, social sciences. It's very clear, we can say, difference, cultural differences among different countries or different societies, that's quite easy when you work in social sciences. But what happens when it has to do with music, or what happens when it has to do with natural sciences? So, Elisa, she defended her PhD on intercultural education in CLIL, so I can say she is an expert in that. She will be talking and she will be demonstrating how to work with interculture in the curriculum of different subjects, not only social sciences, also different sciences as us, for example, music or arts or natural sciences. So she said, CLIL brings the opportunity to promote intercultural awareness through the integration of diverse perspectives and the promotion of tolerant attitudes. This session not only presents CLIL intercultural activities, but it also provides teachers with practical ideas to develop it within subjects such as social science, natural science, and artistic education. So as I told you before, it's not only social sciences, which is the easiest part of that. It will also be kind of difficult subjects such as natural science. Then, on Tuesday morning, from 9:30 to 2, you will have quite an intense immersion in ICT. But I promise it will be very, very participative, it will be enjoyable, and I promise you will learn something. Because Professor Huerta, she's a colleague from the University of Cordoba, also is an expert in ICT, and she knows, I mean, whenever I don't know anything about ICT, she does. So she's the person to ask, okay? So she has proposed kind of a she makes questions about ICT, how and what and when. And then what she does was to review interesting software apps and downloadable
programs that you can use with your students, and that really works. So she said, current technological advances affect all areas of everyday life, communication, collaboration, and of course, learning and teaching processes. This session, divided into two parts, aimed to reflect on the main holistic methodologies for bilingual education, paying special attention to the digital competence for teachers. So, the session will be divided into two big tests because, I mean, when we designed the course, we were aware that she needed time, I mean, to tell the program, to describe the program, to see how it works, and to allow you the chance to really, really work with it. So that's why her session will be doubtful session. Then, the evening of Thursday at 4 o'clock, we will be enjoying the presentation of Alberto Fernández González, his colleague from the University of Oviedo. And he does a very interesting bet for subtitling and audiovisual translation with Bingley. We don't know if you have ever done something similar to this, but we thought it would be like a big, big thing to bet. He said, translation may be used as a teaching resource in CLIL context, aiming to promote active bilingualism and students' cognitive processes. As you can see, we have been dealing with some of the C's in the 4C's description of CLIL. We have talked about culture with Dr. Bennett here. We have talked now about cognitive process, the second C. So we are dealing with the C's. We want to innovate, as I said, within CLIL, and being addressing ourselves right at the core of CLIL, of forces. So we have seen cognitive and we have seen culture, right? Also, Professor Fernandez said, subtitling can trigger students' creativity and stimulate language awareness. So you will see how his presentation will be like very language focused, because he's a great linguist, but he will be very practical. So he will also be able to download, you will be able to download free programs that you can use, and probably, as Rosario said before, start thinking on your final online phase activity, because probably these kind of resources will be something that you can use. Then on Wednesday, at 9:30 in the morning, we will have here Professor Rodan. He works in the secondary education at Hacken Secondary in Cordoba. It's a very nice bilingual school. The school scores very, very high marks in all the exams the students go through. And he has been working with us in the university for, I can say 20 years. I shouldn't say that because it declares my own age. But it's almost 20 years that I've been working with Antonio. He's so nice. You will see how interesting it is to listen to him. Whenever I listen to him, it doesn't matter if I have written with him many things. Whenever I listen to him, I always learn something. So the title of his presentation will be From Consumers to Producers, Input and Output in CLIL Classes. So Antonio will tell you how to make students the producers of their own learning process. Look at that, he said. This workshop will explore interesting strategies to help students become an input producer by both boosting quantity and quality to second language exposition, and providing opportunities to answer diversity in the classroom. So it's a big challenge, and it has to do not only with the learner, but also with the school. So we will see how he does it. It will be a very practical session once again. On Wednesday morning, second part of the morning, we will have here Professor Matthew Johnson. He comes from the Centro Universitario Cisneros, that is ascribed to the University of Alcalá de Henares. And in this case, we are going to talk about time. time, that we don't have time, the students don't have time, pressure, the learning process all the time. So you will see Matthew Johnson making a big bet about flipping classroom. So you will invert the time that you devote to explanations, to exposition of context, etc. You will see how to make students work on, and then when they come to the classroom, you will work on that theoretical background with them. So the flipped classroom is a very interesting bet nowadays. I mean, he is quite famous, I should say, across Europe. And he has been delivering these talks about in quite many cities in around Europe. So he said, the main goal of this session is to offer an alternative to traditional teaching through an innovative pedagogical approach in which direct instruction moves from the group learning space to the individual learning space. Participants will see how flipped classroom perfectly adapt to Quill through the use of technology, for example, green screencasting and collaborative learning. So, again, this will be quite innovative, and don't be afraid, it won't be a theoretical talk of 2 hours. We promise you will be working. Then, on Thursday morning, first time in the morning, we have Professor Ortega from the University of Granada. This guy is also, again, very interesting. His sense of humor is really, really high. You know him?
Yes.
Oh, so you know him. So, I mean, you also know him. So, is this true? He has a big sense of humor, which makes learning quite, I mean, amazing. Sometimes you can see how enjoyable is when he speaks. And he speaks even faster than me. I'm trying to, I mean, speak very slowly. I don't know if I'm getting that. And if you, I didn't say that. If you don't, can follow me, or if you don't, please raise your hand and I will slow down. You are okay. But José Luis, coming back to him, he is very fast. He speaks very fast, both in English and Spanish. I think even faster in English. So, he talked about, look at the title of his presentation, Care and Love Integrate Learning. Well, that's it. I have to confess that When he sent his title to me in a WhatsApp message, I said, are you kidding? Is that the title? He said, yes, that's the title. Trust me. And I did. And I think I'm very happy that I did. I will say if I'm very happy on Thursday, 11:30, when he finishes. But I think he had a point. And he's an expert also in inclusive education. So, look at the summary of his workshop. He said, in this workshop, a revision of attention to diversity in field context is done. First of all, a revision of some misunderstandings and how the legal documents consider attention to diversity. You know, he's really, really expert in handling legal documents. Something that, for example, makes me really, really I don't want to do that, so I don't want to say the adjective. But for him, that's kind of pleasure. He does it and very well. And he continues saying, the importance of terms such as inclusion, diversity, or differentiation is seen. Then we'll see how a bilingual school should deal with diversity and some examples of procedures to deal with the different levels of circumstances will be worked and developed by the participants. So, inclusion, diversity, and legal documents. So again, you will enjoy and see how to integrate different learners with different backgrounds into the same activities, right? Then one of the key words in the title, mindfulness. I think my feeling is that probably you will enjoy her workshop a lot. He's very Zen type. Cristina Gámez, Professor Gámez, she worked at the University of Cordoba, also a colleague here for some years, there for many years. And she's like the very Zen type. She is, I mean, a really, really person, a very calm person. someone who takes things very seriously. And when she proposed her workshop as mindfulness, I had a look. I did what I had to do in Covadonga, and I designed it. But it was, we needed to see much of that was done across Europe, and we have to say that we found almost nothing. So it's quite innovation, and you will see how useful it is to use mindfulness techniques within a classroom. Yesterday, when we met Rosario, we were having a beer yesterday night, and she said, yes, it works. And it's like, we must say that if you implement those techniques in your own teaching, we can say that probably you will get very, very good results. Probably the learning will improve meaningfully. Look what Christina said. She said, those of us devoting our lives to education usually wonder what we can do to lower our anxiety levels to be more creative in the lessons. In sum, to become better professionals. In this workshop, we will experience both mindfulness and coaching practices that will help us become aware of ourselves and of those around us. But above all, this will provide a holistic approach to our teaching practice. So, her goal, it was mainly to help you, if possible, become better teachers. And I think she has, if some of you can improve being a better teacher, probably there is a technique there to be used, right? And big recommendation, I can't forget Sevan because she reminded that at least 20 times to me. Please wear comfortable clothes to this session. Something comfortable because you are going to be sat on the floor. And if possible, bring a cushion with you from the hotel,
wherever.
Your pillow, if possible, bring it, because we will use it. That's it. I have to say it. That's it. Okay? Sorry? Oh, Rosario, can we ask the hotel for permission to bring the pillows or something like that? We can ask Gloria. We can ask Gloria. So we will go as much as possible to help you. Then, another teacher from the university is Leonor Professor. She's Dr. Sue, Professor Leonor Martinez. She works, in combination. The workshops need to be together because, it's like kind of spin-off of the first, of Professor Fernandez. So, Leonor is going to be talking about design thinking and collective intelligence, right? So, his workshop is really, really connected to that of Christina Fernandez. And the same recommendations here, comfortable clothes and the cushion, okay? She said, born at the University of Stanford, California in the 70s, design thinking is a most fruitful methodology aimed at making the most of people's creativity and collective intelligence in a wide array of situations, including education in general and the bilingual classroom. In this workshop, we will look at the phases making up design thinking and explore practical ways of exploiting its huge pedagogical potential in clean settings in primary education. So, you are going to see how to boost students' intelligence by those techniques, which, as you can see, are not exactly new. But what is new is the implementation of those techniques within degree. For some of us don't really know. In our daily teaching. Then, as I said before, these two workshops are really connected. So the final session on Friday morning will be delivered by both of them. Because Christina was speaking about some things, Leonor will continue, and then in the end, they will like make a whole of those two words just before. So the title is again very like wow. Pause, butterflies, pausing. Active listening, emotions, meditation in the bilingual classroom. Again, don't forget your pillows and don't forget your comfortable clothes. In fact, I have to say another confession. Yesterday, when I was driving here, Elisa and I drove here yesterday, I had to go to her house and collect some stones that we are going to use because she's coming by train. And I said, well, I'm driving, I can't take them. And so we are going to use pillows and stones for meditation, beautiful stones from different colors. So these are the poles, butterflies posing around on Friday. So they say, Cristina and Leonor, they said, in this workshop, we will employ several metaphors portraying butterflies as a means to practice active listening techniques, emotional awareness, and regulation of meditative experiences. The aim is twofold. On the one hand, to pave the way for our students' development in an integral manner, and on the other hand, to help educators lower their stress level in order to foster their personal and professional profiles jointly. So, as you can see, meditation, mindfulness, your cooperative learning, integration, intercultural, ICT. I can't say that this course has been carefully designed to cover most of the areas of field in such a different perspective that we really hope they are useful for you. This has been done from a theoretical and practical point of view. We promise that you are not going to be sat listening to all of us for 30 hours. We promise you are going to be working, and we hope you are working, thinking of your own classroom, thinking of your own students, and thinking how you could use it, if you can use it, or if not, you can use it, right? The final step, it will be Friday, in the second part of the morning. We will be Cristina, Leonore, and I. They are the three teachers who will, and I don't know if Julius or Theo will be probably here, I don't really know. We will be delivering the last part of this course, and where we will explain, we will discuss with you the final online task. We have it designed, we want to show you, we want to discuss. And we want to know if you think that's possible, and we want to know your ideas. Before you go to Moodle and you can download it, we want you to see, to have seen it first, and to have thought about that first, and if there is some modification, if there's something we need to change, it's the time to do it. I mean, the goal of this session is that whenever you go to Moodle to download the PDF and you know what you have to do, you have seen that before. And you know if it's feasible or not, if it's something realistic or not. That's the goal of this session. And that's it. You can say I'm being very efficient. It was like 45 minutes. It was not an hour. It was 45 minutes. And a couple of things more. The first one is two recommendations. Whatever happens, please promise you will do the best to enjoy the course. You need to have the attitude. I mean, because you are going to be faced with different things. And you need to have certain kind of hats to be faced to that. So if your attitude is positive, everything will be going very softly, and we hope fruitful also. Also, expect the unexpected. As I told you before, you are going to have cushions and stones and activities where you are going to actively participate, so something can happen. All everything good, of course, nothing bad. And finally, in addition to the hashtag that the Ministry of Education has created, we have also done special hashtag for this course, which is hashtag in Quill. Wherever, if you have pictures, if you want to say something, if you want to interact, will be more than happy to have you your opinions there, because I think it would be a very good way to participate everybody, right? So, questions, remarks, doubts, something you think we need to know before we start. Whenever it happens to me in the club, when I say in my own teaching, any question, if nobody has a question, I say, there are a thousand questions that they don't want to say right now. But anyway, if you don't want to give your questions right now, you are thinking, that's a very good thing. If you are thinking about the questions, we have like 5 days to discuss the questions. And I hope you will be able to do that questions later on, okay? So that's it. Thank you for listening. One question.
Do you have to bring the opinion with us every day?
Well, not really if you don't want to. If you want to, that would be okay, because the things will be on Moodle. I have uploaded all the presentations and all the templates and all the handouts on Moodle that will be made visible as soon as the teachers let me to do that. So if you want to bring the computer or the tablet with you, it will be good. What I think it will be really useful, because I think there are some computers in the classroom. I think there are like 10 computers, if I can't remember. Back on it, right?
Yeah.
10 computers in the classroom. So, to be working on safe grounds, there are 10 computers. If you want to bring your tablet or something like that, you can work with the templates or with the materials, because it will be on Moodle, so you will be able to download them. But to answer the question, it's not really necessary. If you think you are lighter and your heels are very high, mine, etc., you don't want to be walking on stones with your pills, don't bring them. You will be safe in your hotel. But bring the pillow. So, more questions? No. Who's here?
I have one. There were one task to do, and I think I sent it. I think the first task, there were one task, like make a presentation, and I only write one sentence, and I sent it. I only write one sentence, and I thought it was like the profile,
yeah.
And then it was a task. So.
Okay. No worries.
Okay.
Okay. More questions, guys. No questions. Lovely. So I think we have like time for coffee, for relax, for getting ready for an intense week, and once again. My thankfulness for your choice, my thankfulness for your bet, my really, really congratulations on everybody for being here, and please be positive, expectant, and be ready for participation. Thank you for being here.
So bringing everything with you.